What is up with you guys? Jaylene Nya Elagan and welcome to another video. So for today's video guys, we're gonna talk about the Christmas station IDs of ABS-CBN from 2002 up until present today, which is 2020. So we're gonna talk about that, like we're gonna discuss each of their Christmas station ID, yung konsepto ng kanilang Christmas station ID from 2002, and also kung meron silang official music video rin. So medyo mahaba-haba yan, kaya simulan na natin. If you're interested to that kind of content, you know what to do. Please keep on watching. The way your body syncopates, you're driving me crazy. If you are new to my channel, hello po, my name is Jaden Yael. If you are here for quite some time now, welcome back. In my YouTube channel, I'm doing reviews, reactions, and also vlogs. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, I will appreciate if you will consider subscribing, but I'll appreciate it more if you will click that subscribe button there. Okay, so kung may naririnig po kayong aso na tumatakol, pagpasensyahan nyo na, okay? O hindi ko siya makontrol. So sige, dahil nga medyo mahaba-haba yan, simulan na natin. Start tayo sa 2002. Anyway, I will discuss first yung pinaka-concept ng kanilang Christmas station ID, and then at the end of this video, I will pick my most favorite, kasi medyo marami-rami yan. Ilan yan? 18 lahat. 2002, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, I think 18. Nagbilang pa, no? Pero 18 yan, so medyo mahaba-haba. 2002 ang title ng kanilang Christmas station ID ay Isang Pamilya, Isang Puso Ngayong Pasko. So dito sila nag-start na gumawa ng Christmas station ID, which is dito finiture nila yung mga big stars nila during that time. Actually, hindi ko napanood to kasi I think sobrang bata pa ako noong time na yun. Wala pa ako masyadong idea sa mga Christmas station ID ganyan. Pero si Miss Vilma Santos, si Nora Honor, si Dolphy, at saka si The King Fernando Poe Jr., sila yung mga finiture nila. Actually, marami pa naman eh, di ba? I think Chris Aquino was there na during that time. Sina Jean Garcia, Ariel Rivera, di ba? Kasi syempre, nung mga time na yun, sila pa talaga yung mga sikat, di ba? So, Isang Pamilya, Isang Puso, 2002 yan. 2003 naman, Disyembre Regalo. That was actually a unique station ID according dun sa video na napanood ko, because it only had a monologue of the late king of comedy, Dolphy. So, nagmamonologue siya. But actually, he was discussing about the true meaning of this holiday season, which is Christmas. So, yun naman yun sa 2003. Again, hindi ko pa din napanood yung part na yan. Pero may mga clips sa YouTube eh, napanood ko, napakinggan ko sila. So, let's now proceed to the 2004 Christmas station ID. Ito, ang title is Sabay Tayo Kapamilya. They highlighted the family values, which is at the heart of a Filipino Christmas. So, okay itong Sabay Tayo. Actually, ito, napanood ko siya. Napakinggan ko rin siya. Pinalikan ko siya sa YouTube. Sabi ko, ah, ito pala yun. So, nung bata ako, kinakanta-kanta ko siya. Only to find out na yun pala yun. Christmas station ID pala ng ABS-CBN yun. So, 2004, isa to sa paborito ko. Sa 18 Christmas station IDs na pinuduce nila or meron sila, yung Sabay Tayo Kapamilya, isa yan talaga sa pinakagusto ko. So now, 2005, Magpasaya ng Kapamilya. Despite being 2 minutes long, it is one of the most heartfelt station IDs of ABS. Why? Because no celebrities were featured in its video. Instead, ordinary people and their simple acts of kindness are the stars of the show. So, napakinggan ko rin tong 2005 and okay siya. Ang ganda rin niya. Actually, noon pa talaga magaling na ang ABS-CBN sa paggawa ng mga station ID. 2006, Angat ang Ligaya ng Pasko, which was sung by pop rock band Orange and Lemon. Sikat na sikat to during that time. And Angat ng Ligaya ng Pasko reminds us that the true meaning of Christmas is love and kindness, regardless of the gifts and parties. Isa rin to sa gusto ko, 2006. Hanapin niyo yung Angat ng Ligaya ng Pasko. I'm sure kung batang 90s kayo, paulit-ulit niyo rin tong kinakanta kapag Pasko, or kahit nga minsan tapos na yung Pasko, di ba? Kinakanta pa rin to. So, isa rin to sa gusto ko, yung 2006. So, dalawa na yung gusto ko, 2004 tsaka 2006. Kasi mamimili ako from there, and then explain ko kung bakit. 2007, Walang Mag-iisa Ngayong Pasko. It was all about the sense of community among Filipinos. So, instead of a music video, Kapamilya stars offered warm messages. 2008, May Katuparan ng Hiling sa Kapamilyang Kapiling. Everyone had a different story to tell, but the collective message was of helping one another. Ito, si Sara Geronimo na kumanta nito. So, I think ito yung time na medyo nakikilala na marami nang mas nanonood ng Christmas Station ID. At kung hindi ako nagkakamali, 2008, I think may YouTube na that time. Tsaka Facebook and other social media platforms. So, yung mga tao, unti-unti na rin na mas nakikinig ng mga Christmas Station IDs, diba? Sa mga social media platform. Gusto ko rin actually yung 2008. Isa rin sa gusto ko yan. Na Christmas Station ID nila. So 2009, bro, ikaw ang star ng Pasko. It was inspired by the hit primetime series May Bukas Pa. Of course, kilala nating lahat si Santino, diba? So yung Christmas Station ID nila, bro, ikaw ang star ng Pasko. Yung inspiration na kuha doon. This Christmas Station ID aimed to remind Filipinos to fight and be hopeful after the devastating Typhoon Yolanda. So of course, we know what happened in Visayas region, diba? Because of Typhoon Yolanda. Kaya rin meaningful yung mga Christmas Station IDs ng 2008 kasi matindi rin yung pinagdaanan natin nung taon na yon. So 2010, ngayong Pasko, magniningning ang Pilipino. It focuses on the talented Filipinos who are truly the Pinoy pride. Which is itong ngayong Pasko, magniningning ang Pilipino. Isa to sa madalas talagang ipatugtog even up to now. Naririnig ko pa rin to. Minsan ginagamit pa nga to sa pangangaroling ng mga bata. Minsan naman sa mga Christmas party, ito pa rin yung special number. Basta, itong ngayong Pasko, magniningning ang Pilipino. Lagi ko pa rin itong napapakinggan. 2010 pa to, ah. So, it means 10 years na, diba? Pero, kahit hanggang ngayon, LSS pa rin yung mga tao. So, 2011, the best ang Pasko ng Pilipino. Gustong-gusto ko yung konsepto nito. Because the Philippines is rich in Christmas traditions from Simbang Gabi to giving aguinaldos. It highlights how Filipinos around the world celebrate Christmas. Kasi I think kakaiba talaga yung celebration sa Pilipinas eh. Kasi, di ba, October pa lang, nagsiselebrate na tayo. Even yung mga mall, makikita mo nagsiselebrate na. Tapos si Sir Jose Marichan, makikita mo all over social media. So, ang ganda ng konsepto nung song na to, yung The Best ang Pasko ng Pilipino. So, 2012, lumiliwanag ang mundo sa kwento ng Pasko. It pays tribute to the ordinary Filipinos who showed heroism after the devastating events of 2012. Ang ganda rin itong station ID ng 2012. Actually kasi it started in 2008. Inabangan ko na yung Christmas station ID ng ABS-CBN. So medyo familiar na ako talaga sa lahat ng mga Christmas station IDs nila. So 2013 naman, magkasama tayo sa kwento ng Pasko. It featured Kapamilya artists, extended a hand to different individuals and groups with touching success stories. Ang ganda din ito, yung magkasama tayo sa kwento ng Pasko. 2014, thank you ang babait ninyo. They put a new and emotional story behind this popular Christmas jingle. Kapamilya stars prepared special surprises to the people they consider as blessings. Ito yung isa din sa hindi ko makalimutan kasi alam ko the voice coaches eh, ang kumanta nito, which is ang ganda rin. Thank you for the love, yung 2015. Kasi instead na mga singers, which is nasanay tayo na ganun, di ba? Mga ASAP singers ang kumakanta. So yung Thank You For The Love, led by Love Teams, Jadeen, Liz Ken, tsaka Kat Neil. So sila yon. It was all about expressing gratitude and giving back to kapamilyas with inspiring personal journeys. So 2016, isang pamilya tayo ngayong Pasko. Honor the kapamilyas who work hard to overcome challenges and achieve their dreams. 2017, Just Love ngayong Pasko. Through viral photos and videos that show compassion, it highlighted the power of love and kindness. 2018 naman, Family is Love, share the stories of 5 families from different walks of life. This is a reminder that we all have a family to support and love us through any challenges. And then 2019, Family is Forever, celebrating 65 years in the service of the Filipino. So this station ID invited kapamilyas featured in previous Christmas station IDs through the years to be reunited with their favorite artists. Ang ganda ng konsepto ng 2019 actually. Kaya may mga nagsabi, di ba, na parang pinagtagpi-tagpi lang yung mga Christmas station IDs from the previous years. Pero actually, konsepto talaga nila yon na mag-reunite yung mga artists at saka yung mga natulungan nila in the past. 2020, ikaw ang liwanag at ligaya. Amidst all the challenges of 2020, ABS-CBN is determined to continue spreading positivity. So sabi ko sa inyo, medyo mahaba-haba. But if I'm gonna choose my top 5, 2004 is one of my favorite. 2006 as well. 2008, 2012, 2013, and of course, 2020. But if I'm gonna choose, actually, 6 yun eh, yung pinaka-napili ko. Out of 18, diba? Pero kasi ang galing talaga ng ABS-CBN sa paggawa ng station ID. So, kudos talaga. Sobrang galing talaga nila pagdating sa bagay na yan. But if I'm gonna choose only one, I will still pick the 2020. Ikaw ang liwanag at ligaya. I don't know, but maybe because matindi talaga yung ginu-through ng EBS-CBN this 2020 and sobrang tagus talaga sa puso yung station ID nila. That's why I'm choosing 2020. So how about you? If you're gonna choose from the 2002 Christmas station ID of EBS-CBN hanggang sa 2020, anong pipiliin mo? Comment down below, share your thoughts. Why are you choosing that Christmas station ID? I would love to hear your thoughts and read your comments. Thank you so much for watching this video, and I hope I'll see you again next time. Bye for now. The way your body syncopates, you're driving me crazy.